1962 was when Kennedy faced off with Premier Khrushchev of the Soviet Union. See, back in 59, Cuba's Revolutionary War had made it a tiny communist country right near the U.S. shore. That same year, the U.S. had made a deal on Turkey's border. The U.S. troops in Turkey to fire into Russia on our border. Flash forward to October 1962 again. Soviet troops are found in Cuba, was ours in Turkey right near then. The chiefs of staff told JFK this was a good occasion to get rid of Cuba's new government with a big U.S. invasion. But Kennedy said no, because those dudes were awfully frightened. If we strike Cuba, he said, Russia might think attacking us would be the right thing. And that could lead to nuclear war, and of all options, that's the worst. So Kennedy said, before invading Cuba, let's try something else first. Then one night on TV, he announced the plan he made. We'd stop Soviet shipments to Cuba with a strict naval blockade. But when Khrushchev got this message, he said, you're risking war! You can't just stop our boats, he said, this blockade we will ignore. And when the U.S. got that message the night of October 23, defense went up to DEFCON 2, the highest nuclear alert in history. Back then, the U.S. was just one step from launching its nuclear weapons. And as the blockade began stopping the ships, no one knew what would happen. A Soviet agent named Bowman in the States said, hey, I've got an idea. Let's just try to trade before this escalates. Bowman said, if the U.S. promised to leave Cuba alone, maybe then the Soviets could promise to take those defensive missiles home. But then Khrushchev tried a better deal to make a missile recall work. So the U.S. should leave Cuba and take their nukes out of Turkey. So Kennedy agreed to never invade Cuba, and he also secretly agreed to take those nukes off the Turkish land. That part was kept a secret, so Kennedy could still look tough. But the fact is that both leaders thought things had gone quite far enough. Kennedy died in 63, Khrushchev lost power in 64, and that's the closest the world has ever been yet.